And a pleasant good evening and welcome to North Idaho College for tonight's Scenic West Athletic Conference action between the NIC Cardinals and the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. This is Dick Haugen as we join you inside our broadcast booth. The Cardinals, well, they're a perfect 21-0 on the season, and they have got it going, coming off a big victory over CSI this past Saturday in Twin Falls, and the Cardinals want to keep it going here at home. We'll see what the coach had to say. We'll hear from him right after this quick timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
With Cardinal coach Corey Simmons as the Cardinals back home to take on Colorado Northwestern tonight, Eastern on Saturday. And let's go back last Saturday, a big victory against CSI, tough win on the road, and a game that we really wanted to reach or win for several reasons.
Yeah, you know, it's a great win down there. It's a tough place to play, one of the toughest places in the country to play. So it's always nice to get a win down at CSI. Then it's also nice because we have the regional tournament there, so we want to make sure we go down to the regional tournament next time with some confidence in that gym. And so that was one of the biggest reasons we want to get a win down there, is kind of get familiar with that gym and that's the city and kind of what we're doing down there for regionals.
And that game was kind of almost a replay of the Salt Lake game. Salt Lake, you're able to get up by 20, and then they were able to break it down to 8, I believe it was. We're up 19 on CSI. They were able to get it down to 6. What was the difference in being able to wrap that up, to finish thing up, and what you attribute the little slide there?
You know, we've had that problem all year. We've been up about 20 on just about everybody, and we always let them back in it. So a little bit of it is maturity. You know, we got a bunch of freshmen and sophomores, so they kind of get ahead and they relax a little bit, and you can see that watching film that we kind of relax, get a little careless with the basketball, not making smart decisions. So that's the biggest thing, is just kind of making sure we take care of the basketball and make good decisions down the stretch.
And I thought down the stretch, once again, free throw shooting as a team, we're only shooting, we're actually number one in the conference in free throw shooting, a little over 72%. But in that ball game, we were close to 85, 86, making the one and ones, the double bonuses down the end.
Yeah, which is huge. And you really look at the statistics. And lately here, once league started, we've really been shooting a high percentage, because early on in the year, if you remember, we were shooting like 40 or 50%. So in order for us to get that percentage up to 70-something, we're shooting well down the stretch. So it's been good. You know, our guys are getting to the line that need to get to the line. They're making free throws. The nice thing is we're just playing together and playing for each other, and we just got to continue to do that on a daily basis.
Now the team 21-0 overall, 6-0 in conference, ranked 4th in the country. Things are getting kind of fun, aren't they?
They are. They are. They're getting fun, but they are getting a little stressful, you know. Talking with Joel Bates down at CSI, the AD, and he said sometimes it's always nice to get that loss. And, you know, you feel a little bit – every win, you feel a little bit more pressure, a little bit more pressure. But, you know, we're just – you know, our motto is – BJ came up with our motto. We're just 1 at a time, you know, 1-0. You know, right now we just want to be 1-0 after today. So we're going to keep doing that on a daily basis, just trying to win 1 at a time, and we'll let it handle itself.
Got to ask you, so how do you keep – you know, things are coming out. You've been on the job a year and a half. A recent poll just came out. Jared Fay from CSI ranked the top JUCO coach in the country. You were ranked 15th after a year and a half. How do you keep things on an even keel from your standpoint?
Yeah, you know, that's always tough to do. But first, congratulations to Coach Fay. You know, he's done a great job. He suffered some injuries and things down there, but, you know, I was with him for 11 years here. He's a great coach, and I'm glad to get to see him hit the top of the polls there. You know, and I'm just blessed to be in that 15th spot of the year and a half. You know, it really has nothing to do with me. We all coach the same ways. We all do the same stuff. It's just the players that you get in. You know, Coach G and our staff done a great job of recruiting. We've got a good group of guys, and we just got to stay level-headed. Literally, it means nothing. Like, you know, I talked to a couple coaches And just remind us, 21-0 means nothing. You know, we're one game ahead of Salt Lake in league. So we just got to go game to game and try to win this league, which is a tough league to win. We're just going to go game to game and try to do that and not worry about the polls or what anybody else is saying. We got to kind of keep that stuff on the outskirts.
And of course, one of those trap games tonight, as they say, Colorado Northwestern team looking for its first conference victory. I think they're 2-19 on the season. Adrian Hayes has done a marvelous job with that program, despite what the record might show. But, you know, I can remember going down to Rangeley, Colorado, and coming home with an L and not being very happy about that. What are you doing to make sure your team doesn't look too far down the road?
The nice thing is we just got to go day to day and, you know, just make sure we stay in the moment here. Adrian's done a great job with that team. They come out and play hard, so we just got to match the intensity. If we can match the intensity, I think we'll be all right. Playing in our home gym, you know, that's been our motto from the get-go is to win at home, hold court at home, don't let anybody come in here and beat us. So we're going to keep that motto tonight and try to get a good win tonight and get us moving a little momentum into Saturday.
I think it was BJ that also came up with protect this house.
Yeah, protect this house. You know, everybody says that, but we do. That's our goal, is to protect this house. You know, I've been in this league for quite a while now, and we've always said the philosophy to win the league is to hold home court and split on the road. So we're trying to hold home court here and kind of keep that into the bargain.
All right, we'll see if they can keep it going tonight. Fourth in the country, 21-0 overall. Coach, appreciate your time.
Thanks, Dick. Appreciate it.
All right, Corey Simmons, starting lineup, send the tip-off after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
And welcome back to North Idaho College, just about ready for tonight's action. The starting lineups are being announced by PA announcer Gary Day, and we can catch up with the NIC starters.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineup for your North Idaho College Cardinals. From Victory Park at Madrid, Spain, a sophomore guard, a 6'3", number 1, Lucas Antonin. From Garfield High School in Seattle, Washington, a guard at forward at 6'7", number 4, B.J. Blake. From Bushman High School in Seattle, Washington, a sophomore guard at 6'7", number 21, Caleb Warner. From Lake City High School in Colorado, a sophomore forward at 6'7", number 22, Kyle Geis. From Finley Prep at Villanueva, Columbia, a sophomore guard at 6'6", number 11, Ryan Bellows.
So we'll give you the starters for Colorado Northwestern. We were having some issues, and we didn't get quite to them. Starting at a guard, a 6'2 sophomore, number one, Cameron Coles. Starting at a guard, a freshman, number three, Trey Puckett. At a guard, a 6'4 freshman, number 13, Corey Martin. A forward, a 6'5 sophomore, number 20, Van Merben. And in the middle, a 6'10 sophomore, number 24, Jonas Santana. So it's Coles, Puckett, Martin, Merben, Santana for the Cardinals. Antonez, Blake, Angola Rodas, Warner, and Kyle Geist. The Cardinals are a perfect 21-0, and they are ranked fourth in the country. It'll be B.J. Blake jumping for the Cardinals. And jumping Jonas Santana for the Spartans. Angola Rodas inside B.J. Blake. Kyle Geist mishandled it. Cardinals will open in a man defense. Inside to the big fella, and Santana gets the bucket, and the Spartans are on the board first. Angola Rodas, long three. Got it. Brian Angola Rodas from way beyond the arc. Brian had only 8 points at CSI, and you know he wants to get that back. Brian second in the conference in scoring at 22-2. Rayon Blake is number one at 22-6. So the Cardinals remain 1-2 in conference scoring. Their offense, just under 94 a ball game. That is also tops in the Scenic West. Cardinals on the double team. Try to force it inside, stolen by B.J. Blake. Inside, Caleb Warner. Tried to get it to Antonez. Long shot. Santana doesn't get it. Not sure that's a shot that Adrian Hayes is looking for. Antonez, open three. Too long. And a foul called on Van Merben, who sent B.J. Blake a flying. Inside B.J. Blake, off the glass, up and in. Inbounds. 18 minutes remaining, first half. Cardinals and a man. Driving to the baseline, partially blocked by Angola Rodas. Quickly the other way, Antonez goes strong to the lane and puts it down. Lucas Antonez, and a timeout called by Colorado Northwestern. 17:41 remaining in the first half. We'll be right back after this break from Idaho Central Credit Union.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
Cardinals are ranked fourth in the latest NJCAA poll. Only three teams in all of college basketball are undefeated. Two in the junior college ranks, NIC and Gillette, and SMU in the NCAA Division I. And we have injury substitution as Valerian Salumu comes into the ball game. 6'4 freshman. Boy, he gave the Cardinals fit down in Rangeley. The big guy is a lumbering dude. He's big. Cardinals now in a 2-3 zone. Seven on the shot clock. Three on the shot clock. Coles in the lane. Wild shot behind the basket. And shot clock violation. Cardinals forced a turnover. Colorado Northwestern now in a zone. Antonez between the wickets of B.J. Blake. And a technical foul has been called on B.J. Blake. And good bounce as Puckett shoots the technical. And I should have left it up there because he got it. So BJ will sit down for the moment, replaced by Scott Turner. 16:56 remaining, not quite sure what. Didn't look. BJ was not being demonstrative or anything, but. They rang him up. Coles. Inside, the big fella doesn't get it. Kyle Geis grabs the board, and here come the Cardinals. Angola Rodas, no foul called. Brian was looking for a foul on the jump shot. Corey Martin charged with the undercut. Caleb Warner throws it away. ...16-13 remaining in the first half. Coles, eight on the shot clock. Antonez charged with the reach in. Second team foul. Coles open three, doesn't go. Rebound inside, and Santana will go to the bucket, or actually go to the free throw line, shooting two. Kyle Geis, the personal foul, third team foul. Santana, a 56% free throw shooter. And a lane violation on Salumu, who just came in late in the lane to try to get a rebound position. But after you hand the ball off to the free throw shooter, you can't do that. 15:38 remaining first half. Kind of a sluggish start for the Cardinals. Colorado Northwestern in a zone. Scotty off the glass and in. Scott Turner gets the bucket inside. Martin looking for somebody to go to. Coles. Brian Angola Rodas charged with a foul. His first. B.J. Blake into the ball game for Kyle Geis. Haywood Irwin coming in for Caleb Warner. Michael Cooper in for Santana of Colorado Northwestern. Three ball, Cooper. Hit the shot clock above the basket, out of bounds to NIC. Full court pressure, Colorado Northwestern. And Antunes promptly throws it away. Martin in the lane. Doesn't go. B.J. Blake with a rebound. Cardinals with a 3-on-2. B.J. Blake goes all the way. Missed the lay-in. Scott Turner with an offensive rebound. And a foul is called on Cody Martin. Corey Martin, the personal. So Scott Turner will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Van Merben getting set to come back in for Colorado Northwestern. I think he was bleeding from somewhere, and he had to go out and get attended to by the Cardinal training staff. And Merben replaces Corey Martin. Scott Turner, a 64% free throw shooter. .14:30 remaining first half. Don't forget our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals, Dylan Okoro from Newark, New Jersey. And Scott Turner charged with a foul, his first. Salumu will go to the free throw line to shoot two. That guy gets a lumbering in the lane, and he's a handful. 65% free throw shooter. Sam Dowd in for Lucas Antunes. So the Cardinals have Haywood Irwin, Scott Turner, B.J. Blake, Sam Dowd, and Brian Angola Rodas. .14:14 remaining first half. Northwestern in a 2-3 zone. Ten on the shot clock. B.J. Blake for three. Doesn't get it. Ball is loose. And Merben tracks it down. Long three, doesn't go that time by Merben. Haywood Irwin with a Cardinal rebound. B.J. Blake, Haywood Irwin. Scott Turner open from 15, doesn't get it, and Merben with a rebound. Cardinals now in a man. Inside, big fella doesn't get it. Cardinals with a rebound. Angola Rodas. Bounce pass, B.J. Blake. Reverse lay-in is good. Ryan Angola Rodas one of the league leaders in assists. Seventh in the conference in assists at nearly four a ball game, amongst all the other things that he does. Three ball, Coles got it, and it rattles and drops. And Cardinals want a quick timeout. It'll be a full timeout. We'll take one as well. 12:31 remaining. We'll be right back after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
Welcome back to North Idaho College, 12:31 remaining. In this first half, Cardinals will get the shooting stats here in just a second. Here they are shooting 56 from the field, 5 of 9, 1 of 2 from beyond the arc, 50%, 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Early in the ballgame, B.J. Blake with 4, Scott Turner with 4, Brian Golorodos with 3. Colorado Northwestern shooting 20% from the field, 2 of 10, 1 of 4 from beyond the arc, 3 of 5 from the free throw line. Cameron Coles with that 3 leads Colorado Northwestern in scoring. 12:31 remaining in the first half, a slow start for the Cardinals, who are tops in the conference in scoring at 93.4 points per ball game. So now Colorado Northwestern with some full court pressure. Trey Birch Manning checks in for Brian Golorodos. Out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. Cardinals can't believe the call. Coles in the lane, doesn't get it, foul Trey Birch Manning. Coles at the line, 75% free throw shooter. We talked a little bit about this in our pregame show. This is what you call a trap game, where you're the heavily favored and you sometimes don't put out your best effort. Haywood Irwin grabs the board. Colorado Northwestern back in the zone. And a foul inside. Jonas Santana. Boy, they're calling it tight here. First foul on Santana. Fourth team foul on Colorado Northwestern. B.J. Blake inside. Partially blocked inside by Santana. Cardinals get the rebound, however. And a new shot clock. Offensive foul, Trey Birch Manning. .11:51 remaining, 13-8. Ball inside, knocked away by B.J. Blake. Trey Birch Manning with the Cardinals with a 4-on-2. B.J. lost control of it. And they call Sam Dowd with a foul. Sam went down to the floor, and the rebounder, in that case, was Santana, just basically tripped over him. And they call the foul on Slam and Sammy. Eighth team foul. And are we shooting 1-1? I've never seen two of these referees before. I know Neil Peterson. So we'll walk down the other side and shoot free throws. So Colorado Northwestern in the bonus with 11:30 remaining in this first half. Santana, 56% free throw shooter. Ryan Angola-Rodas getting set to come back in the ball game for Scott Turner. Cardinals not in this first 8.5 minutes are not looking like the fourth best team in the country right now. Haywood Irwin, open three. Rattles out and Coles with a rebound. Santana. Coles inside, blocked out of bounds by B.J. Blake. 11:02 remaining first half. Ten on the shot clock. Three ball. Cooper got it. Colorado Northwestern has tied it up. Quickly ahead, B.J. Blake lays it up and in. B.J. ran the court that time. Kyle Geis with a kick ball. It'll be out of bounds. Colorado Northwestern, 10:32 remaining first half. Cooper, top of the backboard, out of bounds to the Cardinals. Ten 21 remaining first half. Once again, our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals, Dylan Okoro. Redshirt sophomore. Try to get in to B.J. Blake, bad pass. Santana with a steal. Ten on the shot clock. From the left elbow. Shot doesn't go by Mervin. Gets the rebound. Off the glass and in. Angola Rodas stops and shoots a three. B.J. Blake, offensive rebound, too strong. And Coles comes down with it. 9:20 remaining first half. Santana, seven on the shot clock, Coles. Offensive foul on Mervin as B.J. Blake takes the charge. Second foul on Mervin. And a technical foul has been called on Mervin. That's his third. So that adds the technical and the personal, so he's going to have to sit for a while. And he's getting the talking to from Adrian Hayes in his fifth year at Rangeley. Brian Angola-Rodas, second in the conference in scoring, 22.2 points per ball game. .857, Cardinals will inbound it. Officials are being a little appearing to be a little thin-skinned. I didn't see anything demonstrative from either B.J. Blake or from Van Mervin on both sides. And Coach Adrian Hayes still asking, why'd my guy get a T? Angola Rodas. Caleb Warner, open three. Rattles, bounces. Angola Rodas gets the offensive board, missed it. Ball is still loose. Angola Rodas gets it back. Off the glass, doesn't go. And a foul inside called on Colorado Northwestern. Michael Cooper called for the foul. He'll come out. Alex Therrien replaces him. And that's the seventh team foul on Colorado Northwestern, so both teams are in the bonus. And Adrian Hayes still trying to get an explanation from the official. Corey Simmons trying to get an explanation from the other official. Cameron Coles now rung up with a technical. Caleb Warner with a Cardinal foul, and then a technical call on Cameron Coles. So, oh, wait a second. Now, it didn't make sense, because if the foul is on Caleb, now, not sure what's going on. All I know is Brian Angola's at the free throw line to shoot two, because the foul can't be on Caleb. Or, well, apparently there was no technical because they haven't shot the tee yet. So I don't know if that was a mistake by the PA or what the deal was. So the Cardinals want to take a timeout. Maybe we should too. We'll be right back and try to figure things out.
Hi, Jim Parker, Sonny and the girls going for a bike ride. This popular Subaru Crosstrek is easy on your fuel budget and can go places most others can't. The Crosstrek hatchback has elevated ground clearance with a rugged off-road suspension. Our locally owned dealership assists customers with a no-problem sales philosophy, putting your budget and needs as our chief priority. Test drive the Subaru Crosstrek at Parker Subaru, Highway 95 and Coeur d'Alene.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. Fourth-ranked and undefeated NIC Cardinals taking on Colorado Northwestern, who is winless in conference play. And 8:26 remaining in the first half. And look at this. Cardinals only up by four. Caleb Warner back in the ballgame for the Cardinals along with Kyle Geis. Coles blocked at the lane. Offensive board is in. Santana hits the boards. Quickly, the Cardinals come the other way. Haywood Irwin floats it up. No good. Santana with a rebound. And Colorado Northwestern can tie it up with a bucket. Ooh, traveled. Yes, he did. Lucas Antonez back in the ball game for Sam Dowd. 7:39 remaining. Unbelievably, only 19-17. Colorado Northwestern last in the conference in scoring, last in defense, last in field goal percentage, last in three-point shooting. Angola Rodas doesn't get it. Kyle Geis taps it out. Lucas Antonez runs it down. Geis open from the corner. Doesn't get it. And Colorado Northwestern with the rebound. This crowd sitting on their hands, not a whole lot to cheer about here. And Antonez with a foul. And a media timeout, 6:56 remaining. We'll be right back after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
I think there's an air stagnation alert floating over Rolly Williams Court here, shooting in the first half of the Cardinals. 28% from the field, 6 of 21, 1 of 5 from beyond the arc, 6 of 6 from the free throw line. 7 points by Brian Angola Rodas to lead the Cardinals in the first half. Colorado Northwestern, not much better. They're shooting 28%, 5 of 18, 2 of 6 from beyond the arc, 33%, 5 of 9 from the free throw line. And Santana leading Colorado Northwestern, he has 6. So Puckett can tie it up. Puckett sits down, and Corey Martin back in the ball game. .6:45 remaining, first half. Wide open, B.J. Blake inside. Nice pass, Brian Angola Rodas. Long three. Salumu puts it down. The big fella from beyond the arc gives Colorado Northwestern the lead. Inside again, B.J. Blake. Therrien moves it around. That's Martin back to Therrien. 10 on the shot clock. Santana over Geis. Short. Angola Rodas with a Cardinal rebound. Haywood Irwin open. Got it. That was a 2. 5:36 remaining first half. Three ball, Therrien doesn't go. Kyle Geis with a defensive board. Inside, B.J. Blake off the glass and in. Cardinals are force-feeding B.J. Blake, and he's hungry. 5 minutes remaining, first half. Cardinals and a man. Inside Santana. Working on Kyle Geis. Coles, four on the shot clock. And he traveled. Owen Mullen, or Mellon, coming in for the first time for Colorado Northwestern. Salumu gets a breather. Valerin Salumu, 6'4 freshman, averaging just under 9 points and 3.5 rebounds. He's had good games against the Cardinals. Caleb Warner, open three. Doesn't go. B.J. Blake, offensive board. Goes back inside and lays it in. B.J. Blake coming alive here in the last 5 minutes. Coles. Stolen by the Cardinals. B.J. Blake in the lane. Lays it up and in. And a blocking foul, and it counts. B.J. Blake. Third foul on Corey Martin. So Martin will have to come out. Trey Puckett comes back in. Kyle Geis gets a breather for the Cardinals. Ziggy Sathwaite in for NIC. Don't forget our halftime guest, Dylan Coro, on Meet the Cardinals. BJ gets the three-point play. Cardinals up by 10. Coles, nice shot. Angola Rodas, Caleb Warner, open three. Doesn't get it. Haywood Irwin, offensive rebound, has it blocked. Ziggy gets it back. Offensive foul, Ziggy. So that was a 10th personal foul. So Colorado Northwestern, since that was player controlled, they will not be shooting free throws. And there's a steal. Inside, Brian Angola Rodas lays it up and in. Three minutes remaining, first half. Brian trying to exhort his teammates on here. 3-ball, Puckett, short. Cardinals with the rebound, ahead to B.J. Blake. Spin move, B.J. with a left hand, doesn't go. Ball is loose, and Therian comes out of there with it. .229 remaining. And he traveled on the baseline. Yes, he did. Mellon didn't get the ball down. Coming back in is Michael Cooper. And Owen Mellon will get a seat back in the ball game. Salumu. Valerian Salumu. He is a load. Angola Rodas. Caleb Warner, open three. Rattles, doesn't go. Cardinals are not hitting from beyond the arc. Under 2 minutes remaining. Cooper short air ball. Caleb Warner. B.J. Blake, open three. Doesn't get it. Ziggy with a rebound. Cardinals will reset, 1:30 remaining in the first half. B.J. Blake inside, off the glass and in. Colorado Northwestern has no answer for B.J. Blake inside. Cardinals with their largest lead. Salumu in the lane, doesn't get it. Satterwhite with a rebound, under a minute. Caleb Warner, open three, doesn't get it. Haywood Irwin taps it and Ziggy runs it down. Haywood Irwin tries to three, and he doesn't get it, and it hits the shot clock. Cardinals just can't get a three ball to drop. 38.3 seconds remaining. Chris Bell into the ball game for the first time. Kyle Geis in for B.J. Blake. Cardinals should get the last shot of the first half. About an 8-second difference on the game clock and the shot clock. Game clock shows 28. Salumu. Ten on the shot clock. 17 game clock. Puckett. Salumu, five on the shot clock. Three ball, air ball, Caleb Warner with a rebound. 8 seconds remaining. Angola Rodas throws it away. 2.8 seconds remaining. Sam Dowd in for Brian Angola Rodas. Keeping Brian from getting a late foul. Coach Corey, I don't know if you could hear that. He said no foul. A runner off the glass doesn't go by Therrien. And there's your halftime score. The Cardinals lead by 12, 36-24. Coming up next, our halftime guest, it's Meet the Cardinals. And standing by is Dylan Acorio. We'll talk with Dylan right after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. Which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Time for Meet the Cardinals as we talk to the Cardinal players, both on and off the field activities, maybe some of their lights, something that you may not know about. And once again, joining us is big fella Dylan Okoro from Bloomsville High School in Newark, New Jersey. You're a long ways from home.
Yes. Long ways from home.
Have you been watching? I guess you're supposed to get a lot of weather. What's up with the people in New Jersey when they get a little snow? They go crazy, don't they?
For real. I heard there was a 70-degree winter this Christmas.
70-degree winter, and now they're going to get about 2 feet of snow. Are you glad you're here?
I'm glad I'm here.
All right, let's talk a little bit about how you got here to North Idaho College. You came to NIC by way of New Mexico Military Institute. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, it's a big difference. Military, we get rules, regulations. Over here, there's a little more freedom, but I think the military school prepared me to handle myself over here.
So is it? Were you going to be in the military itself, or are you going to go on to an academy, or talk about that?
No, I think I was just using basketball to pay for my education. And it was an opportunity, so I took it.
Smart man. Talk about some of the differences. Now, a lot of folks, military academy, thinking of going to classes where you roll out of bed at 1 o'clock and go to a class. A little different at the academy, wasn't it?
Yeah, they wake us up with alarms at like 6 a.m. Got to get up. If you're late, got to deal with punishment, consequences.
Consequences for all your actions. What did that teach you?
It taught me responsibility, you know. Hold yourself accountable, pretty much.
And coming to North Idaho College, before you landed here, were you familiar with the area at all?
No. Coach G just showed me pictures of the lake and, you know, convinced me this was a good place to be.
He gave you kind of a Chamber of Commerce thing there. He picked you all the highlights, right? The boats and stuff on the lake?
Yeah, definitely.
You get a chance to do any of that?
Yeah, in the summer we had a little time off. Coach gave us a little time off before workouts.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about the team coming into tonight's ball game. 21-0, good group of guys that you're playing with, aren't they?
Good group, man. I'm blessed. I'm really blessed to be with a part of this team. Never have I ever been like undefeated more than 10 games. You know, I think we really have something special going.
We do have something special going. And a lot of times it's a one-in-a-lifetime situation. Do you talk to the guys about that? And do you bring any of the things that you learned at the military academy to the floor here, whether it be in game situations or off the court?
I try to help out any way I can, man. Whatever the team needs, I'm there. And I don't know. We're just a big melting pot. We have different parts of people from everywhere. So we mix together well.
All right, who's the yin and the yang? In other words, who's the real straight type of guy and who's the crazy one? Now, I'm thinking BJ might be kind of the crazy guy. Who's the real serious, astute guy?
Say Kyle Geis. That man's about his business.
But he's an assassin.
Yeah, a killer.
All right, let's talk about some of the off-field stuff. Now, I know a lot of the guys like to play FIFA. They like to play their video games and that type of thing. Lucas says he's the king and just about everything video. You get into that, or are you just kind of sit back and watch those guys go crazy?
Once in a while, I'll, you know, hop on the sticks, beat them.
Beat them?
Yeah.
Is this a throwdown here for you and Lucas, sir?
Oh, man, I don't know. Yeah. Once in a while.
Yeah. How about that military academy getting you set for long bus rides to Rangeley, Colorado, 16 hours on a bus? Anything prepare you for that?
Yeah, we used to be on the bus all the time, so it's really nothing.
This guy's tough. I mean, the old guy like me on that. My goodness, when we're out on the road, if there was a restaurant anywhere in the world that you've in your young life of experience that we could pull up to, and the coach said, yep, we got a new restaurant, we want to tie this one up. What kind of food would that be?
And I'll try some African food, man. Some African food.
I mean, what would that be? A leg of a hippo or something like that?
Nah. Regular stuff, you know. Just different ways to make it.
Now, that's key.
Yeah. Definitely.
I tell you, I wouldn't mind. I ate alligator once. I tried alligator. I don't know. I was waiting for it to bite back. I know that's a sick joke, but that was pretty bad. It kind of an oily taste. After basketball, college degree, what do you want to do with the rest of your life after basketball?
And I want to go into banking. I want to go into banking, get my finance degree, work my stocks, you know.
Speaking of stocks, you've been watching the stock market lately?
I've been watching lately.
It bothers me. I'm getting up there, man. My money's going the wrong direction. Maybe you can give me some financial advice here?
Hopefully one day, man.
All right, so he wants to be a banker. 6'8" banker, and the guy is ripped. Give you a handshake. Hey, he means business. Hey, anybody you want to give a shout-out to?
B. Angola asked for a shout-out, so I'll shout him out. But shout-out to the whole team, man. Let's just keep working and getting better every game.
All right, meet the Cardinals. That's Alan Okoro. We'll be right back.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm, you know, from...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica, life moves, live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Anslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
When looking for a vehicle, what do you want? A big selection? The lowest price? More for your trade? Great customer service? Or do you want it all? Tom has it all at Lake City Ford. Come see our showroom with the easiest and friendliest sales staff you'll find anywhere. Giant factory rebates on America's best-selling truck, Ford F-Series. And at Lake City Ford, you can always buy new Fords at bargain prices every day of the week. Nobody sells, services, and discounts Fords like Coeur d'Alene's Ford Giant. Tom Addis, Lake City Ford, 315 Clayton Avenue in Coeur d'Alene, or visit us at LakeCityFord.com.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. It's halftime with the Cardinals with a 12-point lead as we welcome you inside our broadcast location. Not a good half for the Cardinals, shooting 38% from the field. That was a little bit better around the first part of the first half. They're shooting under 30%, 14 of 37. That comes up to 38%. 1 of 11 from beyond the arc, only 9%. The Cardinals couldn't buy a field goal from beyond the arc there. Fifth in the conference in shooting threes at 35%. Cardinals, though, were a perfect 7-for-7 from the free throw line. 19 points, game high for B.J. Blake, 9 of 16 from the field for NIC. The only Cardinal in double figures, Brian Angola-Rodas, with 9 points in the ball game, 2 of 7, including 4 of 4 from the free throw line. As a matter of fact, only 5 Cardinals scored in the first half. 9 for Angola-Rodas, 4 for Scott Turner, and 2 apiece for Lucas Antunes and Haywood Irwin. So the Cardinals definitely having trouble scoring in that first half. For Colorado Northwestern, they shoot 26% from the field, 7 of 27. 27% from beyond the arc, 3 of 11. 7 of 11 from the free throw line, 64%. No Spartan in double figures. 6 points with Santana to lead the way. 5 for Coles. 4 apiece for Puckett and Salumu. 3 points for Michael Cooper. Trey Puckett with 4. And 2 points for Mervin, who, by the way, has 3 fouls along with Corey Martin. So a pair of Spartans in foul troubles. Rebounding in the ball game, it was 15 for Colorado Northwestern, 31 for NIC. Brian Angola-Rodas leading the way with 7 rebounds. Cardinals with 9 turnovers. Colorado Northwestern with 8 in the ball game. Largest lead, Cardinals by 12, right where we are now at the half. 3 lead changes, and there have been 3 ties in the first half. So there's your halftime stats and scoring recap. 4 minutes remaining in the first half. We'll be back with the second half in just a moment. We'll see if the Cardinal pep band is going to strike things up. Let you listen a little bit of their music. If not, we'll just go silent for a couple of minutes with the start of the second half. We'll be right back. about ready for the second half of action. Both teams are on the court getting their final shots in. We'll get our final commercial break in, and we'll be right back after this timeout.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Welcome back to Coeur d'Alene, Idaho for this afternoon, or actually this evening's Scenic West Athletic Conference action between the 6-0 NIC Cardinals against the 0-7 Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. And it looks anything but a Cardinal runaway here tonight, at least in the first 20 minutes. We'll see what happens in the second half as the Spartans will get the basketball to start things here. So they'll be inbounding it right below us. Literally right below us. And here we go. And off of Martin and out of bounds. Cardinals get the turnover. Cardinals fourth in the country. Not looking like it in that first half. We'll see what happens here. Caleb Warner misses the three. Geis with a rebound. New shot clock for NIC. Inside Caleb Warner, and he's fouled by Coles. Cardinals were 1 of 11 in the first half. They missed their first three here in the second half. So 1 for 12 from beyond the arc. By the way, that was the second foul on Coles. Caleb Warner, 60% free throw shooter. Need to give a shout out for Ziggy Sathwaite. Shout out to Janelle watching from Alaska. How are things in Alaska? Caleb gets 1 of 2. Ball knocked around, out of bounds too. NIC. Brian Angola will inbound it. Angola Rodas tried to pass it inside to B.J. Blake, stuffed by Santana. We'll see what the Cardinals do defensively. Mervin, Coles, drives the lane. Bounce pass around his ankles and out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Boy, that's tough. You get a bounce pass around the ankles of a 6'10 guy. Colorado Northwestern will have to hurry. Mabin inside, nice jump hook. Antonez, a little runner, got it. Lucas Antonez with his first points of the ball game. Inside Mervin, knocked away by Kyle Geis and a steal. Caleb Warner, open three. Doesn't go. 1 for 13 from beyond the arc. And a travel. Cameron Coles just kind of, like he kind of rolled his ankle a little bit. Just one of those weird things where you just kind of misstep. He's lucky he didn't really turn an ankle. He's tugging on his right shoe a little bit. 18 minutes remaining in the ball game. Cardinals up by 13. One thing, NIC has been a second-half team all year long. And a foul called on Coles. That's his third. Second team foul on Colorado Northwestern. Coming back in as Alex Therrien in for Coles.
Now checking in for the Spartans, number four, Alex Therrien.
Cardinals will have a new shot clock. Geis open three. Doesn't get it. And a foul called on Colorado Northwestern. And that's the fourth on Corey Martin. So Adrian Hayes finds himself in a whole lot of trouble. Angola Rodas. Kyle Geis open three. Doesn't get it. One for 15. And a foul on Kyle Geis. Geis's second, first team foul on the Cardinals. Santana at the line to shoot two. 6'10 sophomore is a 56% free throw shooter. Unhappy with himself on that one. Cameron Coles back in the ball game for the Spartans, replacing Corey Martin. And out and back in. 12-point NIC lead. Seventeen minutes remaining. Inside, B.J. Blake. An errant pass. And here comes the Spartans. Big fella rolls it in over Kyle Geis. 10-point Cardinal lead. Blocking foul as Angola Rodas sends two Spartans a tumbling. And Adrian Hayes goes to the water bucket, almost to the athletic trainer's room. To cool off a little bit. Now the official is talking to Van Merben a little bit. As Brian Angola is shooting free throws. That's kind of strange, talking to somebody when another guy's shooting a free throw. Huh? All right. One more for Brian, 72% free throw shooter. Got it. Trey Birch Manning comes in for Caleb Warner. .16:33 remaining. Cardinals up by only 12. B.J. Blake on the steal. Cardinal pressures defense. Geis open three. Doesn't get it. Oh, 1 for 16. Unbelievable. Think about this team, though. They could make their next 16. Shot doesn't go by Therrien, and Geis grabs the rebound. Angola Rodas, long three. Doesn't get it. I'm losing count. Is that 17? One for 17? It's getting to be like my odds winning the lottery. Puckett. Blocked by Geis. Out of bounds to the Cardinals. 15:33 remaining. Don't forget, we'll talk with assistant coach George Swanson after the ball game and get his take on this. We talked about it in the pregame show being one of those trap games. Three ball, no good. B.J. Blake off to Kyle Geis. Cardinals call. Defense. 15 minutes remaining. Coles. Cardinals up 12. Offensive foul on Coles, who runs into B.J. Blake on the pass off. And that's his fourth. Antonez was back here by himself waiting for somebody to come to throw the ball in, and Angola Rodas had a hurry. Geis, Trey Birch Manning. Gets his own rebound. B.J. Blake. Off the glass, doesn't go. Cardinals, uncharacteristically not shooting well. They're the top shooting team in the Scenic West Athletic Conference, just over 50%. And that's certainly not the case tonight. Kyle Geis, the personal foul. Second team foul on NIC. Things getting a little chippy. Kyle Geis with a foul. That's his third. Remaining. Scott Turner getting set to come in for the Cardinals. He'll replace Kyle Geis. Jonas Santana, 56% free throw shooter. And he struggled tonight. Cardinals, at last count, 1 for 17 from beyond the arc. You know, I think it was Brian Angola. They hit the first three of the ball game, and then since that, it's been crickets. Angola Rodas in the front court. Angola Rodas. Jump shot, doesn't go. Coles with a rebound. And a foul called on Trey Birch Manning. And immediate timeout. We'll get to show you how bad the shooting has been in this ball game. We'll be right back after this word from Numerica Credit Union.
Thank you for taking me out.
This place is beautiful.
It's nice to get away.
It is lovely.
It's good. Ding, 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 ding.
Surprise!
Look who's here.
This place is nice.
Hey, whoa.
Hey, that's fine.
Honey, what's wrong?
We know what gets on your nerves. That's why Numerica makes it easy for members to make the most of their money with lower interest rates on loans, higher rates on deposits, and zero hidden fees. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
Hi, Jim and Sunny with the all-new Subaru Outback. The symmetrical all-wheel drive system has the capability to take you almost anywhere. There's also extensive safety features like driver eyesight assist, blind spot detection, and Subaru vehicle dynamics control. More good news, at 33 miles per gallon, it's the most fuel efficient crossover in America. Visit Parker Subaru, just off Highway 95 in Coeur d'Alene.
Welcome back to Inside Our Broadcast Area. Cardinals shooting 8%. In this second half, 1 of 12, 0 for 6 from beyond the arc. In the ballgame, the Cardinals are 1 for 17. Two Cardinals in double figures, 19 for B.J. Blake, 11 for Brian Angola Rodas. For Colorado Northwestern, they're shooting 50% here in the second half, 2 of 4. They have not attempted the 3. They are 2 of 4 from the free throw line, and Santana has 10 points to lead Colorado Northwestern. So it's been a brutal, say the least, shooting performance for NIC. 1 of 17 from beyond the arc. Sam Dowd in for the Cardinals, replacing Lucas Antonez. Puckett hands it off. Mervin stolen by B.J. Blake. Here we go, behind the back pass. Trey Birch Manning misses the dunk. And I think they're going to call a T for hanging on the rim, but you can do that to protect yourself. And they are calling the technical for hanging on the rim. So Puckett at the free throw line. Ten-point NIC lead. Make it 9. B.J. Blake, or check that, Scott Turner back in for the Cardinals. We'll set the Cardinal lineup. Sam Dowd, Haywood Irwin, Scott Turner, B.J. Blake, Brian Angola Rodas. And they're working on, and now the officials are talking about Coach Corey Simmons and Adrian Hayes. I'm not sure about what. Trey Birch Manning is getting worked on for a bloody nose. He had some tissue stuck in his nose. And Cardinals up by 9. B.J. Blake in the lane. Doesn't get it. Coles. Coles, drug a pivot foot, got away with it. Mervin, 3 ball, air ball. Haywood Irwin grabs the errant shot. Haywood Irwin, B.J. Blake, Ryan Angola Rodas. Inside, Haywood Irwin, blocked. Scott Turner with a rebound, and it doesn't go. Just hung up on the rim. But Scotty will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Sixth team foul on Colorado Northwestern. And now on the other side of the court, away from the camera, Brian doing some houseworking, wiping some moisture off the court. Scott Turner at the free throw line, 64% free throw shooter. Cardinals only up by 9. You're just tuning in. See, it is a shocker. One for 17 from beyond the arc. .12:30 remaining in the ball game. Angola on Coles. 6 on the shot clock. Inside Mervin. Block P.J. Blake. Sam Dowd on the dribble drive. Goes Sammy, goes up, no foul. Blake with the rebound, lays it up and in. And a foul on Brian Angola. And a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. We'll be right back. 12 minutes remaining in exactly.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Welcome back to North Idaho College. This is Dick Haugen. Nice to have you aboard. Cardinals up by 13. It's been a struggle for the Cardinals tonight in this second half. NIC at the last media timeout, Cardinals were shooting 1 of 17 from beyond the arc. Angola with a steal. Angola Rodas going hard to the basket. Doesn't get it. Jonas Santana with a personal foul, his third. And here comes the big fellow for the Spartans, Salumu. He is just a brawny guy. I mean, he is just a man. He looks more like a tight end. He will come in just a second along with Corey Martin, Brian Angola Rodas at the free throw line to shoot two. About the only thing the Cardinals are really doing tonight well is shooting free throws. Cardinals now up by 15. Go the other way. And go to Rodas. Haywood Irwin open three. Got it. How about that? Coach Corey Simmons puts his hands to the sky and says, what about that? Cardinals now up by 18 at the 11-minute mark. Maybe that'll open the floodgates a little bit. In the lane, puts it up and in. Salumu, he's a beast. Sammy Dowd will launch a three. Doesn't go. NIC up 16. Salumo doesn't get it. Turner with a nice rebound for the Cardinals. Tapped away nicely by Puckett. And a foul called on Therrien. And Puckett voiced his displeasure with his teammate's foul. Cardinals in the bonus. And he gets it. Puckett, nice pass inside. Missed the lay-in is Martin, and the Cardinals come out of there with it. Oh, boy. Angola Rodas drives to the lane. Off to Scott Turner. Reverse lay-in doesn't go. And a foul called inside. Foul on Martin, and that's his fifth. Scott Turner will go the free throw line. Scott playing extended minutes today with Kyle Geis in foul trouble and Trey Birch Manning with a bloody nose. Trey Birch Manning had a best ball game of his career last Saturday against CSI with a double-double, 11 and 10. Cardinals can go up 20. Out of bounds right below us. I'll move my graphic so you can see a little better. .9:35 remaining in the ball game. It's been a struggle. And thrown away by Coles. Oh, out of they give it to Colorado Northwestern. Wow. Sam Dowd with a steal. Ahead to Haywood Irwin, who loses it. Coles got a hand on it. Then it went off the Cardinals. And a timeout, 9:25 remaining. We'll be right back after this word from Idaho Central Credit Union.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Ladies and gentlemen, 9:25 remaining. Cardinals up by 19. Don't forget the Cardinals are back in action on Saturday. Utah State Eastern comes to town. We'd love to see you here at Rolly Williams Court. Lady Cardinals at 3, the men at 5. We'll have Coach's pregame show 10 minutes prior to the start of both ball games. Colorado Northwestern will inbound. 9:22 remaining. In the lane, off the glass, Therian with a nice shot. Doesn't go. Santana, jump hook is good. So just like that, a couple of back-to-back buckets. We saw the Cardinals go up 19 on CSI, only to have the Golden Eagles come back within 6. And NIC, they've done that a bunch this year. Scott Turner, B.J. Blake lays it up and in. In the lane, doesn't go. Cardinals get the rebound. We'll go the other way. Sam Dowd gets, is that a 2 or a 3? That's a 2. Three ball, Therian. Got it. .723 remaining. Haywood Irwin, 3. Short. B.J. Blake goes over the bench. Holy cow. Wow. The Cardinal players are just like holding their breath. And you're not the guy that's going over the back of the basket or the back of the bench. My goodness. Don't anybody say B.J. Blake doesn't come to play. Therian blocked by Brian Golorodas.
Sends the line, first bounce, number four, Alex Carrier.
And I think there's some blood on the shorts of Santana. And they're going to have to. Santana's going to have to change shorts. So we're going to take a timeout. And we'll keep it right here. Santana's going to have to go change his shorts. He's got blood on him. Salumu will come in. And Therian will shoot free throws on the block. The foul was charged to Lucas foul was on Haywood Irwin, my bad. Now we'll talk with assistant coach George Swanson at the end of this, see if he can figure it all out. Out of bounds, Colorado Northwestern ball. This is one of those grinder games. Cardinals get a steal. Haywood Irwin. B.J. Blake with a jam. .645 remaining. Nice shot that time by Mervin. 15-point Cardinal lead as we count down, 6:30 remaining. Angola Rodas, open three. Got it, Brian Angola Rodas. Cole. Shot is in. Nice shot. Under 6 minutes remain. .548 remaining in the ball game. Cardinals up 16. Offensive foul. Coach Simmons has been trying to get that call all night long, and he finally got one. Kyle Geist back in for Scott Turner. Angola Rodas launches a long three. Sam Dow gets the rebound. Haywood Irwin from 15. Doesn't go. Mervin with the rebound. Ball is loose. B.J. Blake gets it, and a timeout is called. It'll be a 30. We'll take a short break as well. We'll be right back after this word from North Idaho College. And they're doing more work on the floor. Brian Angola-Rodas will inbound it. Cardinals are 2 of 19 from beyond the arc. Approaching 5 minutes remaining. Inside B.J. Blake. Sam Dowd, 15-footer, short. Three ball, Therrien. Doesn't go. Sam Dowd with a rebound. Cardinals with a 4-on-2. Sammy will go all the way. Nice shot by Sam Dowd. Three ball. Puckett doesn't go. Offensive board up and in by Therrien, the only Cardinal that was in the neighborhood. It was Haywood Irwin, and he misplayed the jump, and that was an easy putback. B.J. Blake inside, lays it up and in. B.J. Blake. Approaching 4 minutes remaining. Coles lays it up and in. Nice move. Under 4 minutes remaining. B.J. Blake from the baseline. Shot doesn't go. You'll look inside, see if they can get it into Santana. And a foul called on Haywood Irwin. Caleb Warner getting set to come back in for the Cardinals. Once again, we'll have assistant coach George Swanson joining us after the ball game. Point lead, 3:34 remaining. B.J. Blake launches a three. Rattles out. Doesn't go. Coles. No look pass to Maben. Under 3 minutes remain. Three ball. Therrien. Short. Kyle Geis ends up with it. Here goes Sam Dowd. And Angola-Rodas was going to pull the trigger, didn't. Caleb Warner goes to the lane and dunks it. Coles from the right elbow. Got it. Nice shot. Cameron Coles averages 5 a ball game. 14-point Cardinal victory or lead. Boy, let's not speak too quickly here. Oh boy. Adrian Hayes goes, "What was that?" And I got to agree with him. What was that? Technical foul, Adrian Hayes. I agree with Coach on that one. I mean, what was that, really? Caleb Warner will shoot two. So Brian Angola Rodas now at the free throw line for two as the Cardinals are in the double bonus. Cameron Coles, Tony Nakarado in the ball game. And a nice shot by Therrien on the little scoop. Out of bounds. Therrien. Drives to the lane. Tony Nakarado gets the rebound. Angola Rodas all the way and lays it in. .114 remaining. Sam Dowd with a foul. It's his second. Coles will shoot free throws. 1-1. One minute remaining. Tony Nakarado called for the foul. Coach Corey Simmons goes, wow, and he puts his hands up and he looks at Adrian Hayes, and Adrian looks right back at him and said, man, hey. And I agree, the Stripes have been brutal tonight. Brutal both ways, so I guess that makes nobody happy. Two officials, two of them I've never seen before. So I'm not sure if they're up from the JVs or what. 42 seconds remaining. Nakarado, fade away, doesn't go. Cardinals will win it, but it certainly wasn't convincing. Therrien from the free throw line, doesn't go, he's fouled. Therrien goes to the free throw line. 92% free throw shooter. Not sure on how many free throws that is based on. But if you're shooting 92%, you're doing something right. 16-point Cardinal lead. Haywood Irwin coming back in. Replace B.J. Blake.
Yeah.
Offensive foul. And Corey Simmons has just gotten a technical. Wow. Stolen by Sam Dowd. Brandon Gola Rodas. Reverse. Slam and jam. Tony Knox with his third foul. Once again, we'll talk with George Swanson at the end of this one. And that will do it. It wasn't pretty, but the Cardinals come away with a victory, 76-62. We'll be back and see if assistant coach George Swanson can explain it all. We'll hear from the coach right after this timeout.
Let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
When looking for a vehicle, what do you want? A big selection? The lowest price? More for your trade? Great customer service? Or do you want it all? Tom has it all at Lake City Ford. Come see our showroom with the easiest and friendliest sales staff you'll find anywhere. Giant factory rebates on America's best-selling truck, Ford F-Series. And at Lake City Ford, you can always buy new Fords at bargain prices every day of the week. Nobody sells, services, and discounts Fords like Coeur d'Alene's Ford Giant. Tom Addis, Lake City Ford, 315 Clayton Avenue in Coeur d'Alene, or visit us at lakecityford.com.
All right, we are back with assistant coach George Swanson with the Cardinals 76-62 winners over at Colorado Northwestern. And I'll let you explain that ball game.
They made it ugly for us, you know, and we couldn't throw it in the ocean at all tonight. So, I mean, you win some bad ones, and that was one of them tonight.
I guess that does fit the definition of a grinder.
Well, you know, along the way, there's going to be those ones that you don't have a good night, and you got to get through that night. And I think tonight was one of those nights.
And of course, when the Cardinals shoot 3 of 25 from beyond the arc, I know I think it was Haywood Irwin or somebody made the shot. And at that time, we were like 1 for 19, and Coach Simmons just kind of threw his hands in the air and he says, like, "No kidding." I mean, you got to tell the guys to what? Keep shooting, I would imagine.
Yeah, well, you know, they're open shots. We got to take them. We got to knock them down. We get a little jacked up at times, and we start getting impatient with stuff. So I think, you know, we got to slow down and be a little more patient.
Yeah, we talked with Coach Simmons prior to the ball game, and I brought up the trap game, as they say. You know, you're rolling around. You're fourth in the country. You're 21-0. You're 0-6. You got a team that's 0-7 in conference coming in your building, and you think it's going to be a cakewalk. And Adrian Hayes had these guys ready to play tonight.
No, I mean, the thing is, when we were down there, it looked the same way when we were in their place. So it's nothing new to us. I just think we got to figure some things out. We got to make shots, you know, when we're open. We got to knock down open shots.
And, of course, Brian Angola and Bray on B.J. Blake, once again, 1-2. B.J., I thought, was key. They had no real stoppage for him inside, although he was 13 of 25, and that's not too bad.
No, it's been consistent all year with those two. So we're looking forward to this week getting a Saturday and moving on from this game and figuring some things out for Saturday. Eastern Utah is going to be a tough match for us.
All right, a couple things to figure out. What might those be against the Golden Eagles of Utah State Eastern?
Well, we're going to have to guard because they have some really good guards. They get in the lane. They shoot the ball well. And we're just there, you know, they get after it. Their record doesn't indicative of what they are. I think they're a pretty good team. They can beat anybody on any given night, so we got to be ready to play on Saturday.
All right, well, this is one where a lot of people shake their heads, but, hey, still comes out with a W.
Yeah, you win the ugly ones.
Yeah, well, this one was capital UG, I think, on that one, but we'll certainly take it. Eastern on Saturday, not a whole lot of time to prepare for the Golden Eagles, but, hey, a win is a win is a win, and it all looks the same in the scorebook at the end of the season.
Yeah, we'll take it.
All right, Coach, appreciate your time. That's George Swanson. We'll move the camera around a little bit as George makes his way out of here, and we'll let you watch the folks as we'll move the camera down as they congregate on the floor here at Rolly Williams Court, and we'll come back and get you final shooting stats as we come back to our broadcast location. Here's the final shooting stats. Cardinals shoot 37% from the field, 26 of 71, 3 of 25 from beyond the arc, 12%, 21 of 23 from the free throw line. That's where the ball game was actually won. Cardinals 91% from the free throw line. Leading scorer, B.J. Blake with 27. B.J., 13 of 25 from the field, 0 of 3 from beyond the arc, 1 of 1 from the free throw line. Brian Angulo-Rodas with 24 points, 5 of 14 from the field. Brian was 12 for 12 from the free throw line. Other Cardinals, Sam Dowd, Lucas Antonez with 4 apiece. Haywood Irwin with 5. 5 for Caleb Warner and 7 for Scott Turner off the Cardinal bench. So a lot of players had offers in the ball game here tonight. For Colorado Northwestern, to their credit, they battled 37% from the field, 19 of 51, 4 of 6 from beyond the arc, 25%, 20 of 29 from the free throw line, 69%, 3 players in double figures, 14 for Therian, 13 for Coles, and 12 for Santana. Rebounding in the ball game, Cardinals out rebound Colorado Northwestern 51 to 34, leading the way for the Cardinals. It was Brian Angulo-Rodas had 7. B.J. Blake had 8, excuse me, for Brian Angulo, 7 for B.J. Leading rebound in the ballgame, Van Merben had a game-high 11 rebounds. So it was a tough one. The Cardinals' largest lead was 19 points, 3 lead changes, and 3 ties. So with the victory, Cardinals improved to 7-0 in conference play, 22-0 overall. Colorado Northwestern, they fall to 0-8, 2-20 on the season. Don't forget, we'll be back on Saturday when the Cardinals will host Utah State Eastern. 3 o'clock for the ladies, the men at 5. We'll have our coaches' pregame shows 10 minutes prior to both games. So a doubleheader victory tonight, the Lady Cardinals and the men both with victories. This is Dick Halcombe. Thanks for joining us tonight, wherever you might be on the World Wide Web. We'll see you Saturday afternoon right here at Rolly Williams Court. Good night, everybody.